Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. I got the crew with me. I got Jay Aketa behind the cam, aka Lux Wave Films. We got Stefan Waller here, S.Waller, S-D-O-T Waller on Instagram. And the reason I'm in his, you know, mega computer mansion, whatever you want to call it, cave fortress, is because I have a lot of questions for him, and he's gonna help us today understand a lot of stuff about computers, because I'm like a super beginner when it comes to computers. Stefan helped me build, or helped me design three computers so far, and we built one. And how many years have you been doing like the computer building thing?
It's been 10 plus years.
10 plus years. So that's why I've come to a mentor and expert himself. So my main question for today is, what is the difference as a music producer? What's the difference between having a laptop set up and then having a desktop tower? Because I see you have a lot of towers. You have one, two, three, I don't even know how many more.
Right.
So what's the difference for a music producer?
Well, ultimately, it's always going to come down to use case. The best of both worlds clearly is going to be the best. Have a desktop at home, laptop on the road. But if that's not an option and you had to pick one, it's going to come down to your use case. For example, there's going to be pros and cons of a laptop. The pros of a laptop is going to be the maneuverability. Sure. You know, it has a screen attached to it. No matter where you go, just open it right up. It's right there. You have a fully fledged PC ready for you to utilize. But the cons, it's not going to last as long in terms of heat is the number one component of, the number one killer of PC components. So it's a small, you know, chassis that's not going to let off heat as a desktop would.
And I've had tons of problems where, like, the laptop, like, for example, all I had was a laptop in a dream. And I remember sitting in my mom's extra bedroom during the height of the summer where it's like 99 degrees because I'm at a higher level, and I had the laptop sitting on my lap, and the little like air vents at the bottom started burning in my lap and left little marks in my lap because it was so hot. I didn't have anywhere to like place it. So heat, you're saying, is the reason my old laptop probably didn't
kick up anymore. Heat. Another reason against laptops is that the components aren't easily replaceable. So it's a small form factor. So typically the companies who make these laptops, they have to solder the CPU to the motherboard. It's not like a desktop where you can just off the shelf go grab another CPU, and if one's done, you know, you just take it out, swap it in.
So you're saying, like, in order to upgrade, you would have to buy a whole new laptop. And spend like $3,000.
When it comes to a desktop, if something goes wonky with one of the components, it's easily replaceable.
That's a good point. Now, going back to the portability aspect, because now that I'm flying, you know, from where did I fly? San Diego to Philadelphia. Me and Jay went to did we go to ATL, Jay? We went to ATL. We went to Miami, we went to La Jolla, we went to, I'm missing something in that, Miami. So I couldn't bring my desktop tower with me to the, you know, on the road. That's too much unplugging in a hotel room, plugging up stuff. It's too much. And I had to rely on the laptop when I went. I don't even think I brought my laptop at that time, but now I do. I actually bring it, and it has to be portable, because when you get to TSA, you have to unpack your bag and like do all this stuff. So with the portability aspect, do you think that's like, step in the shoes of a beginner who has, you know, the world in front of them or her. Girls make beats too. All right. And they're trying to live their dream. They might have to fly to LA. They might have to travel to go to sessions because they're not known. Like, you have to kind of get out there and travel and go to seminars. So is it best that they go with the laptop so that they can go to the seminars, like the ones we had in ATL? Or, you know, Anaheim, bring the laptop to the session and then link up with people on the fly, or get higher quality? Because I will say, from experience, you get a higher quality from the desktop tower recording process because it can handle a lot more, like plugins, it can handle a lot more stress. So
with desktops, there's a lot more airflow, you know, it's gonna get rid of that heat easier. But when it comes to the person traveling, it just depends. Even if someone travels, I'm going to constantly refer back to use case. Because, for example, if there's someone who likes to travel, maybe they don't want to produce on the road. Maybe they can only produce in their element, in their home space. Right. In which case they would still benefit from just a desktop at home.
Okay. So. And then what would they do as far as portability? I guess you could use your phone to handle business nowadays, right?
Correct. Your phone is a computer.
For the admin stuff. Right. Like the stuff like social media posts mm-hmm. or stuff like that you could do on your phone. Sure. And then at home have the high quality recording space sure. with your desktop.
High quality so. Still exists with yeah. the laptop. However, the price increase is going to be substantial because you're still paying for those top quality components except in a smaller form factor.
What's the average cost of a laptop? Like, what's the market looking like? I haven't looked in a long time. So for a general PC laptop that they pitch to, you know, the masses, mm-hmm. what's the average price point? Because I know the higher brands, the more premium pricing brands, mm-hmm. they start at like $2,500, $2,200.
If we're talking like a MacBook or something, yeah, you're gonna pay a few thousand dollars, a few thousand dollars.
Right. Sure. So is that the average, or like are we knocking the price down as far as like the market?
For if we're talking the Mac side of things, mm-hmm. that's always been just a premium, right. know, a high premium. But if we're talking more on the Windows side mm-hmm. of personal computers, it definitely be reduced. It wouldn't be
like half the price.
Possibly.
Just divide it by two. That's the
it depends.
That's the price. But. So the main thing you're telling me is we're talking about those opportunities. Again, we got to step in the shoes of a beginner or somebody right. who's trying to pursue their dream. Geography based.
Geographically
based. Because everybody has that thing, like if you just go to LA, your dreams will magically appear. You know, it's not really the case because online is different. You can be in Pennsylvania linking up with people in California. Right. And I made that mistake too, thinking that moving to San Diego would have been a good thing. Terrible decision.
The power of the internet.
Power of the internet, yeah. True. So step in their shoes. Let's see, let's do like a Libra scale type of thing. So on the right side, we have the laptop, which is the idea that you can travel with it and go to sessions that you normally couldn't do with the tower. Sure. And in the beginning, you have to like do stuff that gets the ball rolling.
Right, right.
You have to do stuff outside of the box. So travelability, portability, making up words, travelability, TSA approved, so you don't have to like mess with stuff when you're flying around. And lower price, well, is it a lower price than like if you did a tower PC? Or are they more costly? Laptops, generally speaking.
Generally, I'd say you're gonna pay more if we're talking the same system specifications mm-hmm. if exact same laptop okay. and desktop yeah right. the laptop is gonna be more
okay so mm-hmm. let's keep it at those two: portability to access opportunities, and then like TSA approved and all that blah blah blah. So then we got the PC side, higher quality, lower price, and what else does a tower have over a laptop? I guess longer lasting.
It's definitely going to last longer. The components, you can off the shelf, just they're very interchangeable when it comes to a desktop.
Right.
But you're not going to be don't get me wrong, with the laptop, there's only, off the top of my head, there's only one component that should be interchangeable by default by most manufacturers, which is like the hard drives. But if we're talking core components, like the processor or if you have a GPU, those things aren't going to be easily changeable. It's just like hard drives.
Interesting. Mm-hmm. So in the case, okay, so most of us have externals anyway.
Oh, right.
So that
like USB externals or something like that.
But if you wanted like an SSD to make it run faster, like the programs, mm-hmm. I guess you could upgrade that way.
Sure.
So I guess the PC is kind of winning in my opinion. Like it's winning as far as price, it's winning as far as quality, it's winning as far as longevity. Laptop, I mean, unless you're really living that like traveling lifestyle, going everywhere all the time, portability would rank higher. So in my opinion, from what you've discussed with me, a tower PC would be the way to go. But living it out, now I'm looking at it like all I have is my laptop right now and external hard drives.
Right.
But that's because I have a high-end laptop.
Right.
So maybe that's where the lines
get. So your laptop, you get desktop performance from your laptop, so.
But that's like high end and a lot of people can't afford that. So we got to step in their shoes. But anyway, I appreciate you breaking that down.
Yeah.
Stefan Waller, S. Waller. Again, we're offering a new service where Stefan's going to guide you through just like a blueprint to build the computer of your dreams in the new computer building consultation service. And also he can build you a computer himself in your PC building service as well. Now that those will be offered at busyworksbeats.com. Again, we got Jay behind the cam directing all this, Lux Wave Films, and it's busyworksbeats.com. Be sure to click that link below to access the new service. It's busyworksbeats.com. Okay.